Performing tonight on the Expressions Classical Series, James Noyes.
Mark Antonio Consoli wrote this piece in 1965, and it was one of the earliest pieces written for tenor saxophone and piano. And what's interesting about this piece is that even though it was written in 1965, it was not premiered until 2002, when pianist Scott Holden and I played the entire work. This is not uncommon among classical composers to have works written and to have them take a while to make it into the popular consciousness of the people that they wrote it for. So this is his Sonatina for tenor saxophone and piano by Mark Antonio Consoli. While most everybody identifies the tenor saxophone, some of you may need an introduction to the curved soprano saxophone. If you were to straighten this out, it may look a little more familiar to you. For many years, the soprano saxophone was straight, but then in the 20th century, makers started doing what they would refer to as an alto-shaped soprano. When the Great Depression hit in 1929, almost every company in the world ceased making soprano saxophones. And it wasn't until the 60s and 70s that they started to become popular again. And so because the soprano saxophone was not really readily available for many years, there was not a lot of music written for it. So in the late 1990s and in the early 2000s, I approached different composers about writing for what I felt was a neglected solo instrument. And one of those composers, his name is Eric Nathan. So I asked him to write something for soprano saxophone, and he did. This is called Imaginings. Thank you. Robert Muchinsky is one of the great American composers. And in the 1960s, he was a professor at the University of Arizona in Tucson, where he met a young saxophonist named Trent Kynaston. And he wrote this sonata for Trent. And I believe that even though the last name, Muchinsky, belies his Polish roots, I think you'll hear a combination of Polish and very American ideas in this, what is a two-movement sonata.
Thank you. Thank you.